Olga Markova of Russia will be up first. And look at the last two. Rematch supreme, Tara Lipinski, and then Michelle Kwan.
And that's a great draw for Michelle because she's such a fierce competitor. After everybody's skated, it's a perfect place for her.
And good for Tara because she'll put the heat on Michelle skate well. I have a feeling.
Lipinski knows our nothing about pressure. Actually, my goodness.
Olga
Markova. Yeah.
Yeah, understand.
Next year.
A little pressure here. Currently in fifth place, entering the free skate from Russia, Olga Markova, 23-year-old from St. Petersburg.
JB, she doesn't have the typical classical style. She always chooses something different and something unusual.
That was a great opening, triple Lutz. Good height. A little bit on the jumps. We saw just such incredible jumping in the men's competition. So many quads, but I do want to correct myself. We actually only saw three quads performed by the men. I said four. I stand corrected, but still, it was amazing to see.
Thank you.
Olga Markova of Russia. Skating later will be Michelle Kwan, who has written almost an identical storyline to that of the U.S. Nationals 2 weeks ago, falling in the short program and opening the door. More to come when we come back. Michelle Kwan has consistently stated that her confidence is fine. She'll get a chance to display that this evening as she gets prepared for her attempt on the ice. But up next, it'll be Irina Slutskaya of Russia, the European champion. And the presentation make that the technical merit marks for Olga Markova.
And actually, these marks really are just right for her because her technical content was not very high.
She had quite a few misses. It'll be interesting to see what they do for the presentation marks.
Oh.
As they go up a little bit.
Appreciating her different style.
Exactly.
18-year-old Irina Slutskaya of Russia, the first Russian woman to win a European title, and she's now done it twice, 96 and this year. Terrific jumper and spinner.
She's actually grown up a lot this year. She's displaying a much more mature style. Even her costuming, I think compared to Michelle Kwan, she felt she had to present a more mature image. But physically, she's grown.
And I would imagine that makes it difficult to manage some of the tough jumps. And here comes a combination that is very tough. Triple Lutz, double toe loop.
Beautiful jump.
Very easy.
This is what her strength is. Triple salchow. Double loop. Little bit of a standstill on the landing, but she was on one foot nevertheless.
Now watch the way she enters into this triple loop. She'll do quickly, right off of the edge, with ease, a nice triple loop.
Air. So it's interesting to see how much she's grown in height this year and how much she's kind of, in a way, struggling with that.
And right there is an example of what you were talking about. With the extra growth, trying to manage these triple jumps, not easy to do. But in fairness to these little girls, they've just got to grow up sometime.
They're not little girls.
right there. She's not dropping off at all toward the end of this program.
Combination's big. She's had five changes of position so far. Performance.
Irina Sluskaya. Peter Carruthers alluded to her conditioning while her mother got her involved in skating when she was young because she used to get sick very often. They thought the fresh air would help. I think it has. Intensely focusing. She is within striking distance. Michelle Kwan currently in third place, hoping to come from behind once again here to win it. As we Irina take a look at Irina Sluskaya, go ahead.
She was really strong. Right here you can see on this triple saukow, good air position, arms right where they should be, and look how easily she steps up into the double loop. Unfortunately, she comes to a standstill on the end. Now the triple flip, unfortunate for her, only a double. We'll see what the judges think of this. Right here in the technical merit, from 5'7 to 5'8, all very consistent,
very consistent
marks. And the presentation scores, well, 5'6 up to 5'8, so a close range for her. She's in first place right now.
Our next skater representing. Well, preparing to step on the ice soon to defend her title here. Michelle Kwan getting ready. And Dorothy, the question is, does she indeed have what it takes to do it?
There is no question, JB, that she does. What has happened to her 2 weeks ago and last night, I think, will only make her stronger. This is how we're used to seeing Michelle Kwan, on top of the world, number one, the reigning queen of the ice. This is not how we're used to seeing Michelle Kwan, making mistakes, her grasp of the ice now slippery.
I was thinking of winning, which is totally stupid or totally dumb because that's what a, you can't go to a competition thinking you're gonna win or thinking at all of winning. It's like, I should just forget about winning or losing because winning or losing, it's coming from inside.
Her first slip at Nationals was compounded by more falls and errors, leaving Michelle with only questions. What happened, and what will happen now?
At home, I never make that many mistakes. And I guess when it happened in Nationals, it was like, oh my God, what's gonna happen? Am I gonna be second, third? It was like, instead of thinking, yes, I'm going to do the next jump.
This was the first real big championship that Michelle ever had to defend. And I don't think she wanted to lose it. I think she wanted to keep the title. So I think going into the championship, she was thinking title. You know, I have a title here that I've got to save. Instead of thinking, this is the best performance you're ever going to see me give in my entire life. I'm going to be the best at this Nationals I've ever been.
And Michelle is here to defend another title, the Champion Series crown. And just 2 weeks after her Nationals upset, it seems now wherever Michelle goes, Tara Lipinski is ready for her.
At Nationals, it was just like, bam. You know, it's like God telling me, you know how many things you've won? You know how well you skated in the last past 2 years? Like, you know, appreciate what you have. And I do now. It's like everything I do now, it's like I don't take for granted.
Suddenly, bingo, reality right between the eyes. So, you know, that fear of what could happen isn't there because she knows what could happen. So now it's like either get out there and be tough and skate or you're going to lose.
Despite her fall here in the short program, Michelle Kwan has already proven she has a champion's heart. Now she has a chance to show how big it is.
I've taken a fall now, but I can stand up and fight again. I won't give up, ever.
And she admits she much prefers being chased than being the chaser. And her coach, Frank Carroll, has been working on her psyche all week long to help her think of this as just another event and not a championship activity. On the ice right now, 26-year-old Sonya Kwiatkowski of Broadview Heights, Ohio. She was sixth entering this free skate. And Dorothy, this is, in fact, her major platform of the season. She will not be going to the world because of her sixth-place finish in the Nationals, lowest since 1990.
That's right. And you know she's worked so hard, and she's certainly the veteran lady at 26 years old. And she'd hope to go to the Olympics. We're not sure if she'll stay in for Nagano. But she skated very nicely here today.
And hats off to Tonya Kwiatkowski, who has in fact been bothered by a blister on her right ankle for the past 3 weeks. And we'll return to the State International Champions Finals after these messages from your local Fox stations. As we bring you back to the steel capital of Canada, Hamilton, Ontario, Tonya Kwiatkowski's marks have her in third place. She came in sixth after the short program. She's in third, Arina Slutskaya, currently in first. As we take a look at Maria Butyrskaya of Russia, 24-year-old from Moscow.
And you just never know what's going to happen with Maria when she skates. She can put it all together with some brilliant jumps and then do some very bizarre things. She's skating to Malaguena. I'm amazed she did that, because she landed without even bending the leg that she landed on.
I have to admit, she lands some of the most incredible jumps from some pretty unusual takeoff positions. But she many times just pulls out of them. She has that great cat-like ability.
Leaning forward on the landing of the triple Lutz. But she certainly lends a maturity to ladies figure skating that I think is very refreshing. And an incredible triple loop.
She's one of the few ladies that can actually do a triple axel. She doesn't have it in her program, but she's an amazing jumper. Very clean.
unfortunately, standing in one position like that for a long period of time really isn't that difficult, and the judges really want to see more movement throughout the performance, more skating.
Yes, they'll look at it as if she's trying to rest.
That's
which
right.
I'm sure she is, but at least be moving when you're resting.
Spirit, who certainly goes her own way, doesn't always show up to practice, but looked pretty solid out there.
I wonder if she can hold on to the second place that she has after the short program.
Well, looking to hold on to first place is that young lady, Tara Lipinski, whose work ethic is superb. For many of you coming up after skating, it'll be your Fox Local News back here in Hamilton after this. And we're back as we are awaiting the marks for Maria Butyrskaya of Russia.
This is with her new coach, Yelena Tchaikovskaya. Many great Russian male champions.
And now the marks for technical merit from 5.5 up to 5.7. Will these be enough to help her hold on to second place?
The marks for presentation.
The presentation marks go from 5.6 up to 5.8, and now she has slipped behind Slutskaya, who is leading.
So Butyrskaya in second place. Third place coming into the skate is Michelle Kwan. And you see her coach, Frank Carroll, preparing her psychologically for her performance. But right now, 14-year-old Tara Lipinski, hometown Sugarland, Texas, training in Bloomfield Hills, Michigan.
Uncharacteristic. Checked out of a double axel, only doing two rotations. Nothing like what we've seen with her.
How will she respond is the question.
Flip. Good and clean. Nice height. Comes her triple lutz.
So far, unfazed by that strange mistake on the double axel.
Well, Peter, we've noticed she has a problem. She rotates right off the ice. What she can't do, she's got to get her free leg through. And that's been a problem for her.
Well, up to now, pressure hasn't seemed to faze her at all, but are we starting to see maybe small signs of that?
I don't think so, JB. I think she's just too young. She's grown up so much this year. She started on the international scene just last year. And this fall, she competed in all of the Skate International Series and really learned how to compete with the big guns. And she's learned a lot, as you can see.
Thank you.
toughest element right here. Actually, two in a row. First, one triple loop, stepping right up into another one. Outstanding.
I say she's responding quite well.
Yes, she is.
Think about it, six rotations in under a second. Amazing. Though the double axel again,
and she nailed it this time.
Triple toe loop. Dorothy, just another walk in the park for Tara Lipinski. Hello.
Good for her. And watch the replay of this double axel. She doesn't get her free leg through, the one that's putting her forward, and it just doesn't get her up in the air to do the rotations.
But she sure came back in this performance. What makes this jump so hard is the first jump, she'll land with the left foot in front right here and then step right up again into another triple. Very difficult to do for anybody, male or female.
One of the good things about being young in competition, when you make a mistake, you have a short memory. And you come back strong. Tara Lipinski came into the free skate in first place. We'll see what the scores are as Michelle Kwan, again, no stranger to coming from behind, fourth in these finals last year, came back to win it.
That's right. And if you're in the top three, going into the finals, whoever wins the long program wins the event.
Yes, and I think it's important to remember that there are two marks in figure skating, the technical merit mark and the presentation mark. Remember how strong Michelle Kwan can be. Tara is definitely a jumping dynamo, but will they give her the high marks on the second mark, that is the presentation mark?
Michelle skated quite nicely in practice earlier. So if that's any indication, she should be strong.
She did. She had a beautiful practice. She nailed every jump. I went up to her and I gave her a kiss and I wished her luck, and she looked like a completely different Michelle than she did yesterday when I said hello to her. She really is focused.
And that certainly is the expression here of Tara Lipinski, waiting anxiously for the marks.
Michelle is in a great position. She's the underdog right now. We know she's a competitor. This is where her strength is. She's a fighter.
And she definitely has to keep attacking. She cannot back off and defend. She has to attack. But here are Tara's marks. Wow.
Wow. Big marks, all right.
But that doesn't surprise me. Think of the technical content. All very deserved. Let's see what happens with the presentation marks. Will they be the same?
5-7. Those are pretty good, but the door is open. There is room.
Tara Lipinski, as it stands right now, in first place.
Our final competitor this evening.
And our final skater of the evening in the ladies'
Michelle
finals,
Kwan.
Michelle Kwan.
giving up, this is what has given her so much trouble. The triple toe loop, two triples in a row. The first one, the second one.
Perfect. She is fighting for every jump and every spin. She's not letting go. Look at this beautiful, beautiful picture of a music box. She's light on her feet. She's great footwork, great connecting steps. She skates with emotion. And she's only 16.
Very important, yes!
At the end of her program, that shows that she's in great shape.
And attacking.
Good, clean triple Falcao.
For her.
Very, very respectable performance.
Dorothy,
it's not the best we've seen Michelle skate, but it was beautiful.
But to have been in her shoes over the past 2 weeks, I would not want to have dealt with that pressure.
The two principals in the showdown, Tara Lipinski and Michelle Kwan. And one thing for sure, the artistry was strong of Michelle Kwan.
And she really shows here that she's aggressive once again. This triple toe doesn't happen because you're just defending. She's really attacking the jumps. She's back with some of these difficult jumps.
And here's the triple flip where she touched down. On the takeoff, her right arm came around a little bit and whipped her around too much, so she couldn't really hold the position on the landing.
And then
and
just
she's completely tilted on the takeoff of that. There's no way she could have landed that.
The first meeting between these two, Michelle Kwan and Tara Lipinski, since the U.S. Nationals, and the upset by that lady there, Tara Lipinski. As Michelle gives that big sigh of relief as well, maybe.
I can stop holding my breath now, can't I?
It's like you were competing out there.
Oh, well, you know, we've been out there not doing what they're doing, but we sure know what the feeling's like.
There's so much drama. Tara Lipinski looks as though it's no big deal whatsoever.
The contrast in expressions.
I saw it and I was like, push.
Tara has
okay.
Nothing to lose. And let's see what's happening next year at this time, JB.
Right now, she wants to find out what's happening tonight.
Right now. So do I.
And, you know, you could see marks that are higher for the first mark for Tara than Michelle. That is the technical merit mark. But the presentation mark, remember, if there's even a tie, it's the presentation mark that breaks the tie.
And you can bet those judges are trying to figure out what to do.
The marks for Michelle.
Well, here they are, the first set of marks, the technical merit for Michelle Kwai.
These range from 5'6 to 5'8. Surprisingly, 5'6 from the U.S. judge.
And the presentation. And these marks are not good enough to put Michelle into the title. She will not wear the crown here. Tara Lipinski. For the second time.
She just
has taken the title and she just found out.
The jumping dynamo continues on.
Wow.
So 14-year-old Tara Lipinski does it again, taking the title away from Michelle Kwan. We'll have more from Hamilton in a moment. No. Final standings for the ladies. Well, the two ladies who have been providing most of the drama the past few weeks in ladies figure skating, Tara Lipinski comes away with the crown for the Fox Skate International Champion Series Finals. Michelle Kwan in second place. In third, Irina Slutskaya. And backstage with our own Susie Culver are the two American women, Tara Lipinski and Michelle Kwan. Susie?
And this is some fine company, first and second. Michelle, we'll begin with you. We've discussed your range of motions that you've gone through. You've displayed such tremendous grace. What were you feeling tonight?
Well, I felt really good. I mean, I just came back from Nationals, and it was a little hard not skating too well there. And I improved from here, but I'm still a little shaky.
World champ, we'll see you at Worlds.
Okay.
And we got to see a different side of Tara, one that had a little bobble at the top, but responded. What were you thinking?
Well, you know, after the mishap, I go, you know, I can't let it affect the rest of my program. You know, it was one mistake and I have to go on before I let it, you know, it affect the rest of the program, and I wouldn't let it happen this time.
Congratulations. Thank job you. Well done. JB, back to you.
All right, Susie, indeed a job well done. Tara Lipinski and Michelle Kwan. Join us tomorrow afternoon as the Skate